Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today with the recently released Dyad, playing it on the PC. It's out on Steam now. It was previously out on PlayStation Network some months ago, I believe. But it's available for $15. I think it's temporarily on sale for $13.50 at the time of this recording. If you like what you see in the video and you want to check it out for yourself, there's a link in the description, so take a look down there. Now, I think there's 27 levels in this game. There's only 8 here because if we go back, there's some more tiers to unlock. Even one called Eye of the Duck with the infinity symbol next to it. I like how each one of these tabs changes the music, but also subtly changes the background. It's got a nice minimalistic tone to it, which I can dig. So let's head over here to 2.67 and go down to the third stage. But it's worth noting that once you do complete a stage, there is a reason to go back to it. Let's check out Dyadic, for example. I've beaten the basic game objective, but then you can do a remix mode and a trophy mode. Trophy mode has a different objective for you, and the remix allows you to customize things like maybe the speed of the music that's playing. It affects how fast your craft is going. Think kind of audio surf. That's probably where some comparisons will be drawn, inevitably. And of course, you have some more options available to you as well. But let's go back and try out Danger. I have not played this one yet. All right, so we're going to start things up here. We're using the arrow keys to move around and X to hook enemies, as it's called. Is this compatible with a controller? And that's how I would recommend that you play. Probably going to be a lot more comfortable because we're going to be spinning in circles. So if you're easily motion sick, this might be a problem. All right, so our objective here. Got to hook pairs, so we're looking for like same color, either orange or blue apparently, and we want to avoid running into the enemies and the square bullets. You lose points if you collide. Okay, so our ultimate goal is to hook 22, so here we go. Spinning around in a circle, I'm the purple thing at the bottom. I'm kind of zooming out here, so let's try to hook both of these blue. You can see how I can aim downrange of these guys and try to hook them. So when my targeting reticule is on them, I hit X to select them. So right now I'm just focusing on same color, so I'm getting 2 blues. Let's get 2 more blues while avoiding those red squares as well. You might also want to be careful if you get seizures, because the last few stages were not this bright and colorful. I hook a pair, I speed up a little bit. So there's lots of colors, man. Those squares are really weird looking and kind of difficult to avoid, if I'm completely honest. So let's just going back and forth, just bouncing around between the blues and the orange. Oh, why did I get that blue? I should have gotten the orange. I'm not paying attention. This game is infinitely more difficult to play and talk at the same time. I'm having to use like both sides of my brain right here and let one talk and one just kind of do what it needs to do to dodge these things. What I do like about this is you can kind of enter more or less a zen state while playing. Like, it just kind of becomes second nature to hook these pairs and try to dodge all of these mini obstacles. And I guess that's why they have the infinite play mode, so that those of you who don't feel like competing for objectives just kind of sit back and relax. All right, so that was sector 1 of 3, but apparently I met the goal of getting the correct number of pairs somehow, some way. And I'm sure this game is going to get significantly more difficult over time, because keep in mind, this was like the third stage of the game. Oh, I didn't mean to grab that blue one. There should be one right beyond it, which I can get now, and then I want to get this orange. Hook them up. So ideally, if you get really good at this game, and it does have a leaderboard, by the way, for those of you who have a competitive nature, what you can do is obviously get good enough at this game where you can just fly through the entire level hooking the entire time. So there's not going to be as many breaks, as many lulls. So this is kind of what I'm talking about. See how we're just kind of going around, just snagging all of these? Oh yeah, this is starting to get into a flow now. So it becomes really rhythmic. And of course, there is music playing in the background, which is integral to what you're seeing on screen, especially depending on which of the game settings you have enabled. If you're playing perhaps the infinite mode, I didn't mean to get the orange one. So let's try to refocus a little bit. Get all the blues. I like the music, I do. And I like the colors as well, obviously. That's really what the game is going on here. It's just kind of that psychedelic, oh no, did I accidentally take drugs feel. I think it is very simplistic in nature as I screw up here. I say that as like I'm showing just how difficult it can be when you're not paying attention. But its simplistic nature is going to allow that many more people to play it. And it has a very high learning curve, I think, in terms of... Okay, sorry, I made the wrong word there. Not a learning curve, but rather a ceiling. Okay, skipping ahead here, I've done all 3 sectors here. I've got 60. Pairs hooked, which is far and above what I needed for 3 stars, apparently. I'm not sure why that was so far above it. And like I said, you are ranked on the leaderboards, and I can view those leaderboards at any point in time. You see who's in first place, got 95 pairs hooked, so there is some competition there, some friendly competition. And as I said, with 27 levels, each of them having three variations, there's quite a bit of replayability here, and I think the remix is where most of that replayability is going to come from, for those of you who are interested in this game, just because, let me just look down here and see what we can do. Drums on or off, collision, washed out, so I guess you can make it where you can't even lose, like you can't even hit things. I'm sure there will be obstacles over time that we're going to have to dodge, aside from just little squares that you can kind of pass through. Infinite play. You can even, what, triggers equal music. That's interesting as well. Maybe the music only plays when you hook things. Not sure exactly. All right, but I'm not gonna mess around with any of that. Let's go back and check out the fourth stage, Admirable Virtues. So we're racing here, and this is primarily supposed to be a racing game. So I think we're getting into the actual first race. Race both sectors in 2 minutes and 30 seconds. I think the idea here is, if you remember from the last level, as I got hooked pairs, I was able to go faster. So I'm trying to like collect my thoughts. So I was like talking so slow. I'm talking very methodically because I'm trying to understand. Okay, I'll stop that now. But I'm trying to understand what's going on. So we're trying to boost through this as fast as we can by getting the pairs, because you can see every single time we do, we get a sweet speed boost. The faster we go, the closer we come to meeting that objective of 2 minutes and 35 seconds. It's a challenging game, and I like the challenge of it so far. It seems like $15 is kind of a steep price, like all things considered. Apparently I collided with one of these things, which you are not supposed to do. So I gotta keep that in mind in the future as well. I don't know why I'm focusing on just the orange circles. I guess that's just because it's, you know, it's my color or whatever, but it's okay. Anyways, as I was saying, I feel like $15 for this may be a little bit steep, because I think that those dedicated amongst you will probably blow through these levels in no time flat. It kind of comes down to how much you can see yourself replaying such a thing. All right. Sector 1 of 2, I believe, is completed in just a minute. You can see a timeline here of various checkpoints and how fast you completed them in to help you make your way up the leaderboards if you're trying to work on a particular sector. So now I feel like I finally understand, at least a little bit, what I'm supposed to be doing here. But it's definitely something that would be so much better with a controller. Oh my goodness, so much better with a controller. I cannot even begin to express how much more difficult this game is with keyboard. I think something that would be improved on this game in terms of the controls, I feel like if I could use the mouse, maybe that would be even better. Like maybe I would rotate around with the mouse and then perhaps just click to hook. I wonder if the developer tried that and perhaps it was too easy? I don't know, because I feel like you could be super precise with the mouse. It is also worth noting that there is a bit of an auto-lock, if you haven't noticed already. Whenever this comes into view of anything, almost no matter how far it is away, with some exceptions, it'll put a nice big circle on it for you. I don't know why I just ran smack into that thing, but okay. So I like the fact that it does have that auto-lock capability, and more so to the point, I like the fact that it distinctly highlights which of these circles I'm actually actively targeting. Because without that, it would be insanely difficult, because you're having to look down this really deep tunnel to figure out where you're going. And it makes it so much easier when it just sticks that big old circle right on top for you to easily see all the way down the tunnel which one you're highlighting. So overall, the gameplay elements are all here for what it's trying to accomplish. I think it succeeds in making a pretty fun racing game, more or less, I guess is what it is technically. It's pretty trippy, but that is part of its appeal, and I completely failed in the 2 minutes and 30 seconds, so I'll take my 2 stars and go home and cry, go to sleep, come back, and throw the baseball again another day. One last thing I do want to mention as we move on to the next level, just ever so briefly. A primary mechanic of this game is the fact that these guys are quote-unquote enemies. So you can see now, this new mechanic is that when I hook an enemy, it creates a circle around them, unlike the one that is made when I'm targeting them. So my goal here is to hook them and then ride next to them to graze them and get points by grazing them. So now my objective is to focus on both hitting as many of these guys as I can in the distance and then grazing all of them as I pass by. So you can see with each level, it's adding new and more difficult and challenging, but yet still interesting and fun gameplay mechanics. Like, this is gonna make it even harder, but not difficult, if that makes sense. Like, there's way more to focus on and think about, but that's a good thing, kind of. I feel like I'm playing a brain exercise right here, trying to get all of this right. I'm also noticing now that whenever I hook these guys, it pushes them back to kind of give me some room to maneuver, which is pretty interesting in and of itself. I don't know, there's a lot going on here. I think that there's more to meets the eye in this game, to be honest. It seems so simple at the very beginning, but like I said, each new stage is a new mechanic added. So hopefully you keep that in mind as you're checking out Dyad. So I just wanted to give you guys a quick look at Dyad. It's not really that in-depth. There's still so much left to this game that has yet been unexplored. 26. So there's 27 levels, so those trophies are probably indicative of how many levels there are in each of these unlocked zones. So you got all of those. You've got this random infinity Eye of the Duck, which I can only assume is extremely difficult. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed this look at Dyad. Again, if you're interested in it, want to play some psychedelic racing, some seizure-inducing, very pretty colors. The visuals are very impressive. Just, I don't know, it really does make you zone out and just kind of relax. And that's another great thing about this, kind of like Audio Surf was, how you could just play on the game modes where you can't lose. You know, you're just cruising around to the music and just trying to, you know, peace out a little bit. You can do that, and I like that. I like that you can go in, play the remix mode, turn off collisions, and just turn on infinite play. Mess around with those options and just go in and chill out a little bit, play some game, listen to some music. The music lineup is really good. Obviously, these are just kind of random tracks, but nonetheless, it still sounds pleasant, I think. If a bit, you know, nerve-inducing sometimes. So anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this brief video. Check out the game in the description of this video. Thank you guys very much for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I will see you next time.